Imagine generating thousands and thousands of rows of realistic data in seconds. Whether you want to make practice data to improve your Excel skills, test your latest spreadsheet models, or build a project portfolio to get hired for a new role, I'll show you how to quickly get data that's customized to your needs. My name's Victor, and for the last couple of years, I've taught hundreds of people how to advance their Excel skills. And today, I'm going to show you a cool new way to use AI for your data generation needs. Picture this situation. You're working on a new project and you need a data set, but generating one by yourself takes absolutely ages. I know because I've tried making my own data for Excel tutorials. I wanted mock data sets that were customized to my exact needs, but it's such a pain to do this from scratch. I've also wasted loads of time browsing the internet looking for data sets that are relevant to my topic. But recently, I discovered a new way to create custom data that's easy, fast, and free. Let's turn to this new tool. It's called Quadratic, and it's a modern spreadsheet that's purpose-built to help you do analysis, create charts, build models, prepare reports, and make dashboards. Plus, it's multiplayer to make working with teammates faster and easier than ever before. Here's a blank new Quadratic workbook. On the left, you can see the sheet chat where you can work with the AI. There are three different options available. The first is OpenAI's GPT-4o. Then we have Anthropic's Claude 3.5 Sonnet. Finally, the default option, which is called Bedrock because it's hosted on Amazon's Bedrock servers, and that's Quadratic's own version of Claude 3.5 Sonnet. We're going to use this default because it's great for Quadratic. And on the right, we have the spreadsheet interface. And in the bottom right-hand corner, we see this box that shows us two different ways to import data, either by uploading a file or by creating a database connection. But we're not going to use either of those because instead, we're going to use the AI to generate our very own custom data. Let's create a dataset of patient healthcare records. I want realistic but fictional data that matches what we might find in a modern hospital. And by the way, if you want to try out Quadratic for yourself, it's 100% free on a personal plan. You can use the link in the description below. So I'm going to click in this box to start chatting with the AI. I find it helpful to start telling it my situation and giving it my request. I'm looking to practice my Excel skills. Please generate a dataset of patient healthcare records. I want realistic but fictional data that matches what we would find in a hospital. Let's also specify how much data we want and where to put it. Now, instead of pressing enter here, I'm going to hit shift and enter to start a new line, and then shift and enter again to go to the next line. Let's create 1,000 rows of data with at least 10 columns and put it in cell A1. Now we could click on this blue arrow to submit our prompt, but I prefer using the keyboard, so I'll just hit enter. And the AI is getting to work. It says it will help to create a realistic healthcare dataset with fictional patient records, and it's starting to write some Python. You can see the columns it's going to use. Now, unfortunately, it's also generated an error, but not to worry because we can just fix it with this button. So I'm going to click Fix with AI. It brings up the Python code. And by the way, I don't know anything about Python, so I'm going to see how good it is at fixing this. Down here in the code chat, you see it's identified the error, and it suggests that we can fix it by converting this to Python int, so an integer. I'm just going to hit apply and run and see what that does. Straight away, you can see it's allowing me to reject or accept the changes. And if I scroll down here, you can see it's marked in red what we're going to remove and in green what we're going to add. So I'm going to click on accept and then close this box. And there we go. There's our data set. Now I'm also going to click on the first cell. It happens to be L1. Let's move over to the left. It seems that it's not put it into A1. So I'm going to go back to L1, which is where the code is. I'm going to press Control X to cut it and then head back to A1 and paste it. I can also reduce the zoom to say 50%, and we can see the data is here. Let me select the first row with Control Shift and right arrow and then make it bold. And then I'll scroll down to see how many rows there are. And we can see there are actually a total of 1,001 rows because there's a header at the top. So it's created the 1,000 rows of data just like that. But what if you want to work with this in Excel because that's what you're used to? We can easily do that. Let's select the first column and then press Shift and select the last column. That will select all of the columns. Then we'll right click to bring up the context menu, and then we'll choose Download as CSV. So then it's downloaded as a CSV file that we can open in Excel. Now we can play with it and do analysis in Excel as usual. For instance, the first thing I might do is press Control T to turn this into a table and then change the format to one I prefer. Just make sure that when you save it, you don't choose a CSV file. You need to make sure you choose an Excel workbook, otherwise you'll lose any of the formatting and analysis you do. Let's get back to Quadratic. Quick transparency note. Yes, Quadratic is sponsoring this video, but all the opinions are my own. And I've been testing it extensively over the past week, and I highly recommend you give it a try. It's 100% free with a personal account, and you can find the link in the description below. I also included a link to the shared workbook that I use in this video, so you can get a view of it inside Quadratic. Now, we just saw that the AI isn't perfect, and I've noticed that every time I use the same prompt, it generates different results. But the good thing is that you can ask the AI to fix errors and adapt to new demands, and this will keep getting better as the AI models are upgraded. More than that, what we've seen so far is just a taste of its potential. Let's dive deeper and see what else Quadratic can do. Instead of generating a fixed number of rows like the 1,000 rows we have here, I'd like to be able to specify the number of rows on the sheet and have the code automatically generate a dataset with that number of rows. How do we make that happen? I'll right-click on sheet 1 and rename it to healthcare. Then I'll add a new sheet, and this time we're going to make a dataset that has residential property sales, so I'll rename this real estate and hit enter. Now in cell A1, I'm going to type in 2000, press tab, and enter rows in B1 and hit enter. Then in cell A2, I'll press control semicolon to enter the current date, February the 17th, and press tab, then type in last list date. So that's going to be the last listing date that we specify. Now I'm going to start a new chat here. I'll click on the plus button to do that. Now we can also access our past chats by clicking on this clock icon here. But do note that old chats are stored locally on the current web browser and they're not shared between different web browsers. So I'll click this again and we can start our new chat. Just like before, I'll start by describing my situation. I'm looking to practice my Excel skills. Please generate a dataset of US real estate transactions for residential properties. Then I hit Shift Enter twice to start a new paragraph so it's easier for us to read. And this time I'm going to add some more requirements. I want you to generate realistic but fictional data with the number of rows specified in cell A1, that's up here, so there's 2000 rows, and with the last property listing date specified in cell A2, that's February the 17th, 2025. Now I also want to specify the columns that we'll have in the dataset. So press Shift Enter twice. Include column headings such as location, listing status, listing date, listing price, sale date, sale price, size, bedrooms, bathrooms, year built, etc. Use your best judgment to specify at least 12 column headings. So the AI is going to try to fulfill our requirements, but before I hit enter, I'm going to add one more paragraph. Don't create the headers first and then work on the Python code. Do it all in one go. Now I do that because sometimes I found that the AI generates two tables, the first with just the headers, and then the second with the Python code that generates the data. But we only want one table, so it's a good idea to let the AI know. Okay, let's submit the prompt and let the AI do its work. It's going to help create a realistic real estate dataset using Python. And there we are. Now I'm going to zoom out like before to 50%. And then you'll see it starts in D1. I'm going to scroll all the way down to the bottom. And there are 2,000 rows of data. Now I'm going to change this from 2,000 rows to 10,000 rows and hit enter. You'll see it's calculating again, and there we go. Now instead of scrolling down, I'm going to press control and down arrow to head to the last row, and you can see it's 10,001. So let's push Quadratic even further. Let's try 100,000 rows of data. So I'm going to enter 100,000 rows and hit enter. So just like that, it's done. I'm going to click on cell D1 and then press control and down arrow, and it shows 100,001 rows. So it's pretty awesome that you can generate so many rows of data to use directly in Quadratic or export to Excel as a CSV file. And as well as generating data, Quadratic can get data from external database connections and online APIs such as Polygon for financial market information, and Open Weather Map for weather forecasts and history. Check out the links in the description below. Now, I've been testing Quadratic for the past week and know that the developers are actively working on making it better. Here's a peek at their roadmap. but they also need your input to create an even more awesome product. So drop a comment below with feedback on what you'd like to use it for and how you want the product to improve, whether it's new features or updates to existing ones. Also, I'll be making more videos on what Quadratic can do, so let me know your ideas on what to test. And if you want to upgrade your Excel skills, check out one of my recent videos here or here.